What's going on, guys? It's Plaska here, and welcome back to Premier League Predictions. This is week number two, and before we actually get into the video, I just want to say a few things to you. Obviously, this is going to be a continuous series of the season. I'm going to need guest after guest after guest to help me do this series. This week, I've actually had three pullouts, which, fair enough, first lad, he just didn't get the content on time, really, and said he'd do it another time. Second person, they said that the work, like, thing, they got anxiety in that. Third person actually recorded it, I got the clips, and then they said, no, please, can you not, because my anxiety's kicking in. Which is fair enough, I'm not going to publicly embarrass anyone like that, or say names or anything. But yeah, you get what I mean, I'm not going to make that person feel like self-aware and all that. Not a chance I will. I actually tried to get a guest on for you this week, and I managed to get one in the end. He's called Jake. Jake's actually a tradesman. And I've met Jake before in Newcastle. I think he's from Newcastle as well. I've known him before. And I actually banged into him in the streets once after, what, like, maybe 6 months of knowing each other. I even know how long we knew each other, if I'm honest. But the link to his Instagram is going to be in the bio. First game, we've got a Friday night delight in Nottingham Forest versus Sheffield United. Both teams are coming into this game after an opening day loss. Obviously, Sheffield lost 1-0 against Crystal Palace. And Nottingham Forest lost 2-1 against Arsenal. I like to say though, Brennan Johnson, when the score was 0-0, I'm sorry, but against Arsenal, against any team, if you threw one-on-one goal like that and you've still got about 25 yards when you're shooting, you should be scoring, especially if the keeper comes off his line. So, in my opinion, that was just a wasted chance. I mean, to be fair though, can we all give credit to Martinelli? That assist was absolutely sexual. Saka's goal as well, unreal. Obviously Nottingham Forest got one back second half, but it just wasn't enough and they lost the game. Moving on to Sheffield though, last week I just thought they looked second best all match. They let Crystal Palace make chance after chance after chance. Admittedly the goalkeeper had a good game, but that's what's going to happen when you've got a leaky defence and you're letting chance after chance go in, then obviously the team's going to get a goal eventually, aren't they? And that's why I'm going for this scoreline in this match. And a fact about Forest as well, before I give my prediction for this game, 30 out of their 38 points last season actually came from home. And that's why I'm going with that route again. I went Nottingham Forest 2, Sheffield 1.
So, just enjoying my lovely holiday in Turkey, but the predictions for this Premier League weekend are as follows. Nottingham Forest, Sheffield United, I've gone for a 2-0 Forest win. They look really good against Arsenal in the last sort of 10 minutes. Sheffield United are in my sort of bottom spot to go down.
Next up, we've got Liverpool versus Bournemouth. Both teams coming into game week two after 1-1 draws. Liverpool away to Chelsea with a 1-1 draw. Nothing to be ashamed of. I thought Chelsea were unreal that day. And Bournemouth with West Ham at home. If you watched that Liverpool game on Sunday, you'd have realised how vital VAR was in that match. I mean, I can't remember. Salah scored for Liverpool, went to VAR, offside. Ben Chilwell scored for Chelsea, went to VAR, offside. Liverpool, I'm a Manchester United fan by the way, in case you didn't know. Liverpool, with a blatant handball appeal, I can't remember who handballed it to be honest, but it was 100% a Liverpool penalty, went to VAR, they didn't give it. It was a clear penalty. I don't care what anyone says, clear penalty any day of the week. However, though, let us have said that Chelsea played really well. I thought Liverpool were second best all game and Enzo Fernandez just ran the show. As for the Bournemouth match, it looked an absolute thriller. Shot after shot after shot, getting in your face after getting in your face after getting in your face. That's what Bournemouth West Ham was. Jared Bowen obviously scored a screamer as he does, and then Dominic Solanke equalised later on in the match. Hey, to be fair though, West Ham could have got all 3 points there. Lucas Paqueta hit the post with a few minutes ago. The thing I'm going to say that's going to let Bournemouth down in this game, against West Ham, they conceded too many chances like I said. This is Liverpool, this is not West Ham United. Last time they played Liverpool at Anfield, they lost 9-0. They let them create chances again, and they'll do them. And that's why I'm going for this scoreline of Liverpool 4, Bournemouth 0.
At Liverpool, Bournemouth again looked really, really good against West Ham on the highlights I saw. A lot of possession they had as well, considering to last season. Liverpool looked woeful against Chelsea, so I'm actually going for a 2-1 Chelsea win, but I don't think Bournemouth will be disgraced.
That brings us on to our next game. We've got Wolverhampton Wanderers versus Brighton. Wolves are coming into the game on a 1-0 loss to Man United. As for Brighton, they're coming in on a 4-1 win over Luton. Honestly, Wolves did not deserve to lose that game. They're the better team than United on the day. Like I said, I'm a United fan, and I'm admitting that. I'm not even joking. If you didn't watch the game Monday night, this is all it was. Man United, cross the ball in, Jose Sarri, if he catches it, I punch it clear. That was literally all it was. And to go to Old Trafford and have 23 shots against Manchester United, I can't name any other teams that do that. I'd say Man City probably could, Liverpool probably could. Other than that, who goes to Old Trafford and gets 23 shots off and 6 on target against Man United? Not many teams. Admittingly though, Onana had a good game for United. I actually thought he won us the game, but he also could have lost us the game. Was it 96th minute, a VAR penalty appeal? Like I said, I'm an honest football fan. I think it was a penalty. Even though I support United, it was a penalty. But Man United should have also had one earlier in the match when Rashford headed it, and I think it was... I can't remember his name, actually. But Rashford headed it was going in, and one of the players literally put his arm out like that towards his stomach and then fetched it in. It was going goal-wise, it yet hit his stomach and his arm, but in my opinion, like I said, he fetched his arm in, and it's a penalty. All day long, VAR, the handball rule actually needs changing football. If it just hits your hand, it should be a free kick and a penalty, just like that. The only thing that actually let Wolves down, I thought, was the lack in finishing, and I think that's going to affect them all season if they don't hurry up and buy a striker. As for Brighton, though, they actually looked so calm on the ball, and it was just a typical type of Brighton performance. Obviously, they had a really good season last year, and I think that the fans are going to expect that as well. Like, I think they're going to expect the same level as that. So I think this is a game where if they get a point, they've dropped two, if you get what I mean. Realistically, they should be going into this fixture and winning. In fact, the past three fixtures they've had against Wolves, Brighton have won all of them, and the combined scoreline is 12-2 to Brighton. And that's why I'm going with my prediction. Brighton 2, Wolves 0.
Wolves-Brighton, I've gone for a solid 2-2. Again, Wolves were in my relegation battle, but after the performance on Monday against United, I really do take that back. I think they are up there for a top 10 position.
Next up, we got Fulham versus Brentford. Fulham are coming into this one off a 1-0 away win against Everton. As for Brentford, they're coming into this one off a 2-2 draw at home against Tottenham. Now, last week, I said about Ivan Toney not being able to play till January, and I'm positive I said Mwemu and Wissa were going to have to get the goals. What happened last week? They both got a goal each, and it was enough to get a point for them. Fair enough. And watching that game, actually, I'd probably say a 2-2 draw was a fair result for both teams. Yeah, Tottenham were a bit like, I don't know, they lacked a bit in the main striker position, if that makes sense. If they had Harry Kane, I reckon they'd have won. But it is what it is. James Maddison's came in, he's got 2 assists right away in his very first Tottenham match. Like I said, Fulham are coming into this one on a 1-0 win away to Everton. But I watched the highlights and Everton absolutely outplayed them out of the park. The only thing Everton lacked in was getting a goal, and that was down to Bernd Leno. In fact, they did get a goal, but it was disallowed. It's one of them where you could go, yeah, I'm on the goalkeeper's side, yeah, I'm on the attacker's side. Leno came out, caught the ball, went into the attacker, dropped it, Everton tapped it in. It's like one of them. My opinion, because Leno's came for it, but you've also got to think that safety on the goalkeeper, whatever it's called. So it's part of the rule. Is it a goal though? I'm going to say yeah. I think the goal should have stood because it's Leno's fault, if you get what I mean. On another day though, Everton could have easily won that game 2-1. If it weren't down for Leno and he had a different keeper in, they probably would have won 2-1. So this prediction I'm going for Fulham-Brentford is a 1-1 draw.
Fulham-Brentford, I've actually gone for a Brentford smash and grab 1-0 win.
Next up on Saturday night, in fact Saturday night's a double header. We've got Tottenham versus Manchester United to kick it off. Like I just said, Spurs are coming into this game on a 2-2 draw against Brentford. Man United are coming into this game off a 1-0 win, which was very lucky against Wolves. As a United fan, I was not impressed with the performance at all. And I just think that Ten Hag won't be impressed by it. He's going to give him a hard week training. And I think we're going to see different Manchester United this week. I honestly do. And I don't want to jinx it, but that Tottenham team without Harry Kane in, it just does not scare me at all, if I've got to be completely honest. And my prediction for this game is indeed going to be Tottenham 0, Manchester United 1.
Spurs United. I've actually gone for a 3-1 Spurs win. I think without Harry Kane, I think he sort of actually hindered them a little bit. I do think they're going to crack on, and Kulusevski on that right is going to absolutely perform, you watch.
Honestly, this next match, I can't wait for it. I cannot wait for it at all. It's Manchester City versus Newcastle United. I could go on forever about this fixture. I really could. Obviously, both teams are coming in off the opening day winners. City won 3-0 against Burnley. Newcastle absolutely humiliated Aston Villa at St James's Park, winning them 5-1. I might sound stupid here. Mark my fucking words. Newcastle United do not lose this game. They will not lose on Saturday. Kevin De Bruyne is out injured, and the club haven't said how long he's going to be out for either. So that's going to be a massive blow to their season, I think. And as for the Newcastle United team, last week I thought they all looked like they played with each other for 5 years, never mind 5 minutes. Everyone on that bench as well could walk into that Newcastle starting team. Obviously, Pep Guardiola is probably the best manager in the world, and if we go back to the fixtures last year, Newcastle versus Man City, they were in fact a 3-3 draw and a 2-0 win to City. Like I keep saying, Manchester City, yeah, admittedly the best team in the world, just done the treble, well done. But like I said, KDB out, who's going to be feeding Haaland? And if, what happens if Haaland gets injured? Because when he was at Borussia Dortmund, he was an injury prone, wasn't he? If Haaland gets injured, I seriously worry for Manchester City in this title race. Yes, not a top four race, title race. If someone says Manchester City are only going to be in the top four race, they clearly do not know ball. Every year before they've even kicked the ball, everybody's talking about them winning the league. If Haaland gets injured, I seriously worry for them. Anyways, going back over to Newcastle, I think they're going to be extremely hungry in this fixture. Like I said, last year, a 3-3 draw at St James's Park, lost at the Etihad 2-0. I think they're going to learn from the errors. And they've also improved the squad massively. Obviously, he's been injured, but he's back now, and he came back with 2 goals last week. Harvey Barnes, he came on, he got a goal. Tonali, he got a goal. He should have had 2 goals in 6 minutes in. And like I said at the start of this rant, Newcastle United will not lose this game. I wouldn't be surprised if they actually went to the Etihad and won. But I'm not going to say they're going to win. I'm going to go with a 2-2 draw.
City and Newcastle, of course, have gone for my team to back them. I've gone for a 1-1 draw. City, again, didn't look amazing versus Burnley. Obviously, it was a 3-0 comfortable win, but they expect that every single game against Burnley. But we are in flying form.
Next up, we've got Aston Villa versus Everton. Obviously, Aston Villa's just been absolutely smoked by Newcastle, like I said. Not normally getting smoked by Newcastle these days, let's be honest. But the defence looked absolutely shit, if I'm honest with you. Admittedly, you could say, yeah, Aston Villa were massively outclassed by a good Newcastle team, which they were. And the difference, I thought, between that game is Newcastle were a lot fitter. And Tyrone Mings going off injured on a stretcher didn't help. Hope for a speed recovery for him, because I actually think he's a really good centre-back, if I'm honest. And if Paul Torres plays like he did again, then I'm sorry, but Tyrone Mings is going to be a bigger miss than everyone thinks he's going to be. And going back to Everton, like I said, they were just unlucky against Fulham. They created chance after chance, and another day they should have beat them. And realistically, they should have beat them. But like I said, Leno had an absolute masterclass in goal. Fair play to him. But I can only see one outcome of this match. Villa Park's going to be absolutely rocking for their first home game of the season. I think they're going to get behind the fans. I think they're going to give them a performance of a lifetime. And maybe not a lifetime, but you know what I mean. I think they're going to mistake what they did last week, and they're going to bounce back this week and go on Aston Villa 2, Everton 0.
Villa-Everton have gone for a 2-0 at Villa win.
Next up, we got West Ham United versus Chelsea. Like I said earlier in the video, West Ham were actually involved in an absolute shot fest against Bournemouth. And Chelsea were in a game where they were in complete control against Liverpool. Bit of a difference between Bournemouth and Liverpool, isn't there? Honestly, if West Ham United let Chelsea have the amount of shots they let Bournemouth have, they could actually be in serious trouble here. We could be looking at a 3 or 4-0. But I'm going safe, I'm going West Ham United 0, Chelsea 1.
West Ham Chelsea look unbelievable. We've gone for a 2-1 Chelsea win.
And the last game on Monday night, we actually have the opener of last season. We've got Crystal Palace at home to Arsenal. I'm just going to keep this short and sweet. Both teams are coming into game week 2 off decent wins. Arsenal 2-1 against Nottingham Forest, and obviously Crystal Palace away to Sheffield United 1-0. Timber is actually out for a good bit of time now. He's done his ACL on his Premier League debut, which is unfortunate for the lad. Absolutely unfortunate. He could be out of 3 to 6 months. Hey, with an ACL, potentially even 18, but I don't think it'd be 18. The way he reacted, he walked off the pitch, didn't he? So Like I said, this was an opening fixture last season and the score was 2-0 to Arsenal away at Palace. And I might sound absolutely boring here, but I'm going for the exact same scoreline as last year. Crystal Palace 0, Arsenal 2.
And Palace-Arsenal, I've gone for a 1-1 just because I don't think Palace at home will win the game.
Anyways guys, that has indeed been Premier League Predictions Episode 2. I hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said, if you want me to do this series continuously, you're gonna have to add my Snapchat, I need guests on it. If I've managed to fix my computer and get the footage off Jake, then thank you Jake for being a guest on the video, it's much appreciated, especially after we've had 3 people pull out and it's basically a last minute choice, if you get what I mean. So if I manage to get a video clip off Jake, then I really appreciate it for that, Jake. Other than that, it's been me, Plasky. Peace out. All the lasses in the world, I think you're poor coach. Even if you're rough as fuck, I still think you are low horse. Wiles and take out with you, be all the funny, it's pure classy. I'll take you back to my house and fucking smash your pasty.